Welcome to a lesson on the last diminisher method. To apply the last diminisher method, a party of three or more are randomly assigned an order. Step one, the first person cuts a slice they value as a fair share based upon their value system. Two, the second person examines the piece. If they think it is worth less than a fair share, then they pass on the piece unchanged. If they think the piece is worth more than a fair share, they trim off the excess and lay claim to the piece. The trimmings are added back to the to-be-divided pile. Step 3. Each remaining person in turn can either pass or trim the piece. 4. After the last person has made their decision, the last person to trim the slice receives it. If no one has modified the slice, then the person who cut it receives it. 5. Whoever receives the piece leaves with the piece, and the process repeats with the remaining people. We continue until only two people remain, and they can divide what is left with the divider-chooser method. Let's walk through an example on how this works. We'll look at an example of dividing up a small tropical island among four players. So we have player 1 through player 4, and we'll go in this order. So for round 1, player 1 claims part of the island worth 25% according to their value system, which we'll call C. Notice each person's fair share would be 25% because we have four players. So this is C to begin with. Now player 2 examines the region. Player 2 decides the region is worth less than 25% and passes. So now it goes to player 3. Player 3 examines the region. Player 3 decides the region is worth more than 25%. So player 3 trims the region, which becomes the new C. And now player 3 is the claimant. So if player 3 trims the region, it may look something like this. So this is the new C, and player 3 is now the claimant. Still goes to player 4. Player 4 examines the region. Player 4 decides the region is worth less than 25% and passes. Therefore, player 3 claims C and is out. So now players 1, 2, and 4 remain, and because there are only 3 players, their fair share of the remaining piece of the island would be 33.3%, approximately. So for round 2, it goes back to player 1. Player 1 claims part of the island worth approximately 33.3% according to P sub 1, which again we now call C. So this would be the new C. Player 2 now examines the region. Player 2 decides the region is worth less than 33.3% and passes. So it goes to player 4, and player 4 examines the region. And there is an advantage to being last in the last diminisher method. Player 4 decides the region is worth more than 33.3%, and since player 4 is last, P sub 4 trims a piece that is essentially 0% and claims the region. So P sub 4 is required to trim the region before claiming it, but because player 4 is last, they can trim almost nothing, so it may look something like this, where it's just a very minor trim. Again, P sub 3 has this piece. This is the new C. So again, going back to the previous slide, player 4 is last, and notice how player 4 just slightly trims it, and now can claim this piece, which they do value as more than 33.3% of the value. So player 4 claims this piece and is out. For round 3, since only two players remain, player 1 and player 2, we use the divider-chooser method. So a coin is flipped, and let's just say P sub 2 is a divider. P sub 2 divides the region into two regions worth 50% of the remaining value, which we see here divided by this blue segment. Player 1 chooses a region, and player 2 receives the remaining region. So just to finish the example, let's say player 1 selects this region, then player 2 would be left with this region here. Everyone receives at least a fair share, then notice how player 4 did receive more than a fair share. Now let's take a look at two more examples. A 6-foot sub valued at $25 is divided among 5 players, P sub 1 through P sub 5. Using the last diminisher method, the players play in a fixed order. P sub 1 is first, followed by P sub 2, P sub 3, and so on. In round 1, P sub 1 makes the first cut and makes a claim on a C piece. For each of the remaining players, the value of the current C piece at the time it is their turn is given in the following table. Let's begin by determining each player's fair share, which would be the total value of the sub divided by the number of players. So each player's fair share is $5. So player one cuts a piece, which they value at $5. Then notice that player two values that piece at $3.50, which is less than the fair share, so player two would pass. So it goes to player three. Player three values the piece at $7, so player three is going to trim the piece, so according to them it's worth $5, and take claim to the piece. And now it goes to player four. Player four values the current piece at $6.50, again more than the fair share. So once again, player four is now going to trim the piece and take claim to the piece. Player four is going to trim the piece so that in their mind it's worth their fair share of $5. And now it goes to player five. Player five feels the current piece is only worth $4, less than the fair share, and passes. And therefore, player four receives the piece, which is valued at their fair share of $5. So which player gets his or her share at the end of round one? This would be player four. And the value of the share, or value of the piece, would be their fair share at $5. The only time it would be more than the fair share would be if the last person valued the current piece at more than $5, then they could essentially trim nothing off the piece, take claim of that piece, and then receive it. Let's look at an example like that. Again, it's the same question, but now the sub is valued at $35, and again, there are five players. So everyone's fair share would be $35 divided by 5, or $7. So player 1 cuts a piece which they value at $7. Then it goes to player 2. Notice player 2's value is less than $7, so they pass. Player 3 values the current piece at $7.75, so they would trim the piece so that the value is $7 in their mind and take claim to the piece. Next, it would go to player four, who values the current piece at less than the fair value, so passes. And now it goes to player five. Again, notice how player five is last, and they could take advantage of this. Player five values the current piece at $8, and player five knows if they trim it, they're guaranteed to receive the piece. So in this case, player five is going to trim essentially 0% off the piece, keeping the value at $8 and receiving that piece. Which means at the end of round one, player five receives his or her share, and the value of this share would be $8. Remember in the last example, the player only received their fair share because they were not last. Let's finish by looking at why the last diminisher method is fair. If player one is left with the initial claim because everyone else passes, then the player got what was identified as a fair share. No one else can take it away without diminishing it. If player two diminishes it, it should appear less than a fair share to player one, as long as player one is fair and not greedy. This would make whatever is left appear potentially more than a fair share. The same argument applies to everyone else. Note that the part removed by a diminisher can be arbitrarily small, and because of this, it does penalize potential greed. Even when the last player received more than a fair share, it's still fair because everyone else valued that piece at less than or possibly equal to a fair share. I hope you found this helpful.